reason.
No, I think there's a lot of fun in the kind of stuff we read, that it was much, I think, a little more fun than Dexter. Dexter.
What's Dexter?
We haven't watched Dexter.
No.
Dexter
is... I don't watch TV too much. It's a doctor?
It's a television serial about a guy who's a cop who goes around catching people and murdering them beautifully, elegantly.
I haven't seen them. I must.
Chopping them into little bits and pieces, and that is the in thing.
Yeah.
I just had a friend of mine, an advertising executive, an excellent writer, Anil Thakrani, who sent me his new book about a guy who keeps chopping up people. He doesn't do anything more than that. Chopping up women. I sympathize with him, but I think it's a bit a lot.
I don't know about chopping up women, Mr. Nandy, since you seem to enjoy that.
Good
luck to you. But it's not something that I would confess to.
No, somebody's actually written a book on it. That's what I'm saying. I wouldn't even think of it.
This is just to safeguard him. If there's any chopped up in a bag, you know who to find. Somebody who enjoys that. So, should we... Anybody, any questions? Anything that you want to know and don't know already? Hi, Khanna.
Hi, Twinkle. Firstly, I'd just like to say a huge congrats.
Thank you.
The book is super. I've read the book. So, for those who haven't, read it. As a mom, as a fellow mom, I really relate. And I think all moms are multitaskers. Guys are as well. But what really resonated for me, and this is why I've been really wanting to meet you and have you on my show, is that, you know, my dad, he was an author, and he was creating a show. And I'd noticed that you've really... Now, I don't know if it's a reinvention, but you've came as an author, and you write very well as a columnist. And honestly...
No. I was planning on writing when I was 65. When my kids have gone, I would go to Goa. I would do some drugs, finally, and just relax. And that was my plan. This all happened to me much earlier in life. I had it down to wearing white kurta, having short nails, never dyeing my hair, going on my motorbike. But life gives you opportunities, and sometimes you say yes and it works out. I don't think anyone can really plan to reinvent themselves. It's probably a plan that would flop, I guess.
No, I think honestly, because having spoken to moms, what I find is a lot of people assume that after the kids, careers may dry up. But I've actually found that they actually can be nourishment for a lot more, you know? So, I mean, I'm just... saying huge congrats to you, because I think you've done that, and you've done that very successfully, and I think it's very admirable.
Thank you.
And of course I know she's doing a lot of, I know the interior store, I know all that, but I think the writing has, you know, propelled you up there.
From one mom to another, high five.
Yeah.
I don't want to really talk about the shenanigans in Bora Bora. It's really sad, and I feel that instead of looking at people like Mr. Kalbergi, who got murdered for having strong beliefs, we are focusing on other things like this. How does this affect anybody else besides them? You know, I mean, and in fact, Mr. Kalbergi's murder affects everyone else who wants to think. So, yeah, that's my job. Thank you.
Inside this...
That was the first piece that actually got me noticed. I'd been writing for a year before that, but that was the piece that got me noticed. Did I think that I would get this reaction? No, I just wrote it. You don't know where it's going to go and how. And I sent it off. I told my husband, I said, I think I wrote this well. And he said, no, let me see and I'll decide. So I was like, okay, you decide, fine. And I fell asleep that night, and the next day it was everywhere. So yeah, that did work well.
Thank you.
I think it's pretty much equally divided. I do look at things from a woman's point of view. I can't help it. It's biological. That's the way I'm made. But I think it's yeah, I'm not male bashing. I might push a woman up, but I'm not really doing that, you know, by making her stand on top of a man. Yeah.
No, what I mean is that we sometimes live under this sort of ancient misconception that the men in our country are still also living under a rock. But do you find that there are progressive... you know, just as progressive as women are today, that there are enough progressive readers of both genders who respond correctly and they get your point of view?
Well, here's one business.
And I wish there were more, let's put it that way.
Anyways.
Thank you, I appreciate it. Every time I write something against, I would say, or not against, but something against a certain political party, I have, I don't know, cockroaches. They just come running out from everywhere and I'm busy spraying hate on all of them. Does it bother me? No, because I might like someone, I might not like someone. But for me to be a person who goes on their page and sort of sprouts venom, I don't know what kind of a person I would be. So I assume that a person like that, I have no respect for, so why should I respect their opinion? Anybody else with questions before we move on? I actually didn't want to write this as my first book. I had a very serious book in mind, a pre-partition book about this family. And my editor at Penguin hit my head with a thesaurus. I lost my memory. I wrote this instead. But yeah, I'm writing something. It's fiction and let's see.
Oh, that's a serious one, is it?
It's not serious. It's not serious.
And she's not telling us that now, if it is.
It's fiction.
All right. Thank you so much, Twinkle. Thank you so much, Mr. Nandy. I think you brought out lovely insights into...